Hey there. So today we're going to do a quick rundown of the analytics tutorials on the site. We're going to start with Tag Manager and getting Google Analytics on Webflow. We've been getting a lot of emails and some of Facebook posts about how to do it. So we're just going to do the, I think, first two. And then I'll start rolling out some more about the rest, just so you don't have to read my long ramblings on the site and keep everything really simple. So I'm going to switch over to Tag Manager now to get us started. So you're going to need a Tag Manager, Google Analytics, and you're probably going to need these plugins. So I'll just give you a rundown. This is the old Google Tag Manager Assistant legacy plugin. Still worthwhile getting, because it just makes it easy. And then you're gonna want to install, what is this? Tag Assistant beta conversions, Tag Assistant companion. DaVinci's probably nice. It's somewhere in here. Anyway, the links are all in the blog post. What is Wappalizer? That's not really important. Okay. So just a quick rundown. I grabbed some template off Webflow, so we have something to work in. Here it is. Let's see who made this. Whose template is this? There we go. Incredible multipurpose website template. It's just a free one that we're going to use to work with. So to get you started, the first thing we're going to have to do is get Tag Manager installed, the second part of our video, which we'll put in the second blog post. We'll be getting Google Analytics into Tag Manager onto the site. So, Tag Manager, you're going to want to open an account, tagmanager.google.com. And then you're in Tag Manager, you're going to want to create a new account. So, a new account, and we're just going to call this test site. We are in South Africa. Container name. So we'll just grab milkmoontest.webflow.io. That's our container. It's actually just the name, it doesn't really matter. And we want web. We're going to go create. Accept everything. Yes. It's loading. Okay, now we've got our container. We want to install Tag Manager. So we're going to grab these two snippets. This will go in the head in your Webflow settings so that it's applied to everything. This has to go in the body tag. Not as easy because you can't actually get it in the body tag in Webflow. But essentially, you'll see here it's a little iframe, no script. So it's the failover for when the guy on top here stops working. So we're just going to stick that into every page on the website using a symbol. So we're gonna grab, okay, let's grab this guy, head over to the site we want to install it in, go to custom code, paste it in here, save, and we'll publish. It's thinking. We're going to go into the designer and once we're in the designer, we're going to want to put a HTML embed on every page in the site. So we're going to go embed. We'll just call the embed Tag Manager. Whoops. We'll open it up again. We'll grab the second piece here, paste that in, and all you want to do now, right click on here, create symbol, we'll call it Tag Manager. And then you want to make sure that Tag Manager is at the very top on every page on the site. So let's see, what do we have in this template? In terms of pages, we got home and utilities. So we're just going to drop this in here when it finishes loading. So again, just select the body, add the instance, drag it up, and one on the password page, one on the 404 and utility pages, just so you know, can track if sites are have issues and whatnot. And we're gonna go ahead and publish it. And essentially that is now that Tag Manager should be installed. So we're gonna go over here. This is the page we just installed it on. We're gonna go enable this. Won't work if you don't do it beforehand. And we're, oh, sorry, whoops, forgot. Yeah, so we have to publish, always publish. So in Tag Manager, go hit submit. You can fill in changes for the version that you're doing. We don't need to do that. We haven't actually done anything yet. We're just gonna go hit publish, sing like no one's listening. We are now on version 2, and version 2 is still loading. Give it a sec. And now if we make sure this is enabled, did I enable it? It's disabled. We're gonna refresh. And you'll see there's a one now, it's picking up a tag. Google Tag Manager is installed. It's gonna moan that the second bit is not in the body. Don't worry, everything will work just fine. And that's getting Tag Manager installed. Simple as that. I'm gonna switch over to the second part, which is in the bottom of the blog post. You'll see getting Google Analytics into Tag Manager. That's it. Cheers.